today we are going to learn how to make a rag quilt using a panel as well as using my no cutting pieces or no cutting squares method. This quilt was not all cut up into individual pieces before. I bought a panel and I will walk you through everything that I did to put this quilt together. So the panel that I have behind me here is a Moda panel. I'll link to that fabric down below if I can find it, if you're interested in doing this exact pattern, but otherwise any panel should do. When you're looking at your panels, look for a panel that has very linear shapes in it and individual squares even. So when I was at the fabric store, I took a few pictures of some of the different panels that I was looking at using for this project. These images are not the best because I was not taking these pictures thinking that I was going to show them to you. However, I think it'll help you get an idea of what type of panel you should look for when you want to do a no-cutting rag quilt method on a panel. So the panel that I chose is actually 34 inches by 43 inches, and then I ended up buying about 3 yards worth of the border fabric because I used that on the back as well. Because we are making a rag quilt, you are going to end up shrinking your rag quilt up quite a bit because you're using half inch seams to create the ragging effect. So you will need more fabric than you think you do. Now, in between those two layers of fabric, you will need some flannel fabric. So I did 2 layers of flannel fabric between my 2 layers of cotton fabric. And for that, I bought about 5 yards of fabric. The next thing to do is pre-wash all of this fabric for 2 reasons. Your flannel fabric is going to shrink at a different rate than your cotton fabric. And because you're working with an image, when you wash it all together, it's going to shrink if you haven't pre-washed it, which is what happened to me. But after I washed it, I noticed that my pictures were just kind of crumpled up and I didn't like that look. Pre-wash that fabric, very important. And if you bought 2 panels and you're going to put them together to make one nice larger panel, that's okay too, but do not sew those panels together ahead of time. We will do our stacking method with our panel and you'll do that for both of your panels separately. And then we will match them up and sew them together the same way that we will add our side borders. Before stacking all of our layers together, just grab your quilter's ruler and trim around the entire outer edge of your panel so that you've gotten rid of all of those selvages. So once you've trimmed and squared up your panel, then it's time to cut the same amount of fabric out of your 2 layers of flannel, as well as a layer of your backing fabric. Now it's time to sandwich it all together. Lay your backing fabric right side face down, and then lay 2 layers of flannel on top of that, finally laying your panel fabric right side facing up on top of that. That will create your sandwich. Now is when we do the no cutting blocks method. Following the first line in your paneled fabric, fold your fabric stack in half, and then pin on the right side and on the left side of that fold, and then work your way inwards, making sure that you're smoothing out any bubbles or wrinkles as you go along. Then you'll take this to your sewing machine and you will sew a half inch seam along that folded edge.
All of my seams are a half inch seam allowance. That is very important because when you do the no cutting method, you're folding your fabric upwards, you're pinning across so that you can get your seam. But if you choose to do a quarter inch seam allowance on that fold instead of a half inch seam allowance, it is going to be so hard to cut down that fold afterwards. Another tip is to use a jean needle because you are going to be sewing through a lot of layers. And of course, when you're sewing, just go really slowly over those thicker seams.
As you can see here, it's created a loop in your fabric on the top part of your panel. This will eventually become your ragged seam. Do this same method for all of the seams that you need parallel to that seam. Once all parallel seams have been sewn, then it's time to finally grab your fabric scissors and cut all the way along that inner loop. Once you have cut all of your loops open, it will be time to work on our opposite seams. So turn your fabric and do the same method we just did across the seams we just created. You will fold open each of the cut open loops. That way you are reducing bulk as you sew across these loops.
loops. And once again, you will sew a half inch seam across each of these loops that you are creating, and you will work your way across the entire panel. And then of course, grab your fabric scissors and cut open these loops as well. This is what the panel portion of your rag quilt will look like when you have finished these steps. If you did this process with two separate panels, now would be the time to put those two panels together. So I'm just going to show you using my single panel. So I'm just going to fold it in half so that you can see what I would do. How I would do it is I would open up my side seams, match them up with the side seams of the other panel, and then lay them so that the back sides of both panels are facing each other. Then sew a half inch seam across that raw edge connecting both panels together. And this of course will also become one of your ragged seams.
And now on to the borders. The borders you can make however big, however small you want them, but consider, are you going to want more ragged seams inside those borders? So for myself, I did 8-inch wide borders, and in the end, I did end up putting one seam down that border. However, if I were to do it again, I would do a 10-inch wide border and then add that seam, because you have to remember, every time you add a ragged seam into your rag quilt, you are losing an inch of your fabric to create that beautiful ragged effect.
So to do your border, measure the height of your panel, add around 4 extra inches to that measurement, and then cut out 4 pieces of your cotton fabric. You'll need 2 of those for the front of your border and 2 for the back of your border. And then of course you'll need 4 pieces cut at the same measurements for your flannel, which will be sandwiched in between those 2 pieces. This will help you have 2 borders, one on either side of your panel. And now before attaching your borders to your panel, have a look at the edges of your panel, and if they are quite wonky, then just trim away some of that excess fabric that's expanding past your panel. And now it's time to add our borders. Sandwich all 4 layers together the same way that we did the panel, with your backing fabric face down, then 2 layers of your flannel, and then your top border fabric face up. So take your sandwiched border fabric and lay it along the back side of your panel. Lay your border fabric so that it matches up to the top edge of your panel where you will start sewing, and let your excess fabric hang past your panel on the bottom end. The reason why we need some of this extra fabric is because sometimes our fabric shifts when we sew our panels together. Now as you're clipping both of these pieces together, remember to open up those previous seams on our panel to reduce bulk as you're sewing that half inch seam all the way across. Once both side panels have been attached to the center panel, then trim away that excess fabric. And if you want any ragged seams in your side panels, now is the time to pinch those and sew those into place as well. And then you will do the same method to attach a top panel and a bottom panel and any ragged seams you would like in those as well.
And now we are almost done doing our panel rag quilt, but now it's time to decide how we are going to finish those outer edges. There are 3 ways that you can do this. The first method is just by sewing a half inch seam all the way around the entire outer edge and then snipping and ragging those edges. The second is to add binding, and I will link to my rag quilt tutorial on that down below. And it's a special binding where you get your ragging effect on the inside of your binding. But another thing with that one is it should really be done with flannel fabric. Adding that rag quilt border that I have a tutorial on might be a bit much. So if you want, you could just go with your cotton fabric and add a regular border, which is in the end what I did on this rag quilt here.
And if you do choose to add a binding, I would suggest squaring up your rag quilt before you add that binding. But if you're just going to do the rag quilt edge, there's no need. Just sew a half inch seam all the way around and then you can get right to snipping.
And when you're actually ready to do the snipping and all of the ragging, I highly recommend this pair of snips here. I have tried a whole bunch of different snips out to do my rag quilts, and this is my all-time favorite pair of snips. So I will link to
to this in the description down below, and you will make snips every quarter inch all the way along. Sometimes you will split up the seam so that you're not cutting through 8 layers of fabric, but rather 4, and then do the other side and snip the other 4. I find that's the easiest. I have a whole bunch of links down in the description below that will lead you to a lot more of my informative rag quilt tutorials, especially that no cutting rag quilt method tutorial, which will give you a really good idea of what I tried to already teach you, and the washing your rag quilt tutorial, which is also very important if you want to save your washing machine. If you found this tutorial helpful, please give it that thumbs up because that really helps YouTube share my video to others, and hit that subscribe button if you want to come back for more future tutorials and you don't want to lose me on YouTube. There's a lot of people here on YouTube, so please hit that subscribe button. I hope that you guys have a wonderful day, and I will see you next time. Bye for now.